The SwiftUI Map in iOS 17 boasts enhanced functionality such as custom annotations, smooth navigation, and advanced gesture recognition, providing users with a highly intuitive and visually appealing map experience within iOS applications. In today's video, I'm going to talk about all of these, so let's dive right into it. Master SwiftUI in 4 weeks. Make sure to check out rebeloper.com/SwiftUI-camp to join SwiftUI Camp and learn it in 4 weeks. With me on a group coaching call in 4 sessions, you will master SwiftUI. Go ahead and check it out. Now, today we are going to talk about maps in the new SwiftUI as of iOS 17. There has been added new APIs, so it's quite amazing. Let's jump right into it. I have added some locations right over here, default locations, so we can just see them, and just started off a brand new Xcode project. Now, what we want to do right over here is, instead of this text, we want to add a map. And as you can see, there are multiple ways of initializing this. You can have an initial position, a position that you can maybe just set up to a state variable. We are not going to bother about this. I'm going to talk about the, and also the interaction modes. You can add in pan, pinch, zoom, or if you just omit it, like we are going to do, you can just simply have all of them added. So this is our map. It's as simple as that. And what we are going to do is add some markers. So let's add a marker. You can have a title, coordinate, and later title, image, monogram, system name. So let's take a look at a few. So starter, let's have a marker with the title. So the title would be, let's just go with the first one, Tower Bridge. And the coordinate, let's choose Tower Bridge. And let's build and run and see how this looks like. And as you can see, we are on Tower Bridge. It's really, really amazing. Again, it's just a coordinate and adding the map view. How awesome is that? Now, we are quite zoomed in onto the Tower Bridge by default. Let's add another marker so we can see a little bit more of the map, like it would be just larger, because it will incorporate that other marker too. And let's just add maybe Hyde Park. So marker and title and then Hyde Park. There we go. Let's build and run. Let's see that. There we go. Now we have Hyde Park and Tower Bridge. Now these are default markers, as you can see. You can use them, but as usual, I like to customize my UI. Therefore, let's check out what can we do with these markers. Great news for all wannabe SwiftUI developers. The doors to my highly anticipated SwiftUI Camp cohort are now open for enrollment. Are you ready to embark on a transformative 4-week journey to master SwiftUI and revolutionize your understanding of dynamic user interface design? Join my thriving community of like-minded learners and, under my guidance, dive deep into the intricacies of SwiftUI. Take the leap and secure your spot now to elevate your skills and become a SwiftUI expert. Join today. The link is down in the description. So first of all, let's have another marker. So just marker, and let's have the one with the title key system image and coordinate. That would be just the easiest. So let's have that as Bank of England. There we go. System image, sterling sign, coordinate, Bank of England. Let's build and run and let's see now the free markers there. As you can see, we have that system image right over there. Also, we can add kind of a tint color for this. Let's just have dot tint and let's just have dot green for that. Okay, let's build and run and see that. There we go. Now it's a little bit more customizable. But what if I want to make this a whole lot of customizable? Also, what if I want to navigate away when I tap on one of these markers? Well, actually, for that, you don't need a marker, you need an annotation. So let's have the annotation. And as you can see, we have title, coordinate, and content. Coordinate, content, label. Let's just go with, let's see, coordinate, content, a label. Yeah, that would be the more flexible one. So the coordinate, let's just have King's Cross, the last one, yes, and then the content and label. Now, the label, let's just have content for the content. Let's have, let's see, label. Let's have a text of King's Cross. Let's see what's going to happen when we are going to add that. There we go. We have King's Cross right over there, but that's not enough. We want to make this really, really customizable. So let's have the content of a V stack. And let's have a text over here. Get your trains here. Whatever. Let's have also an image. Why not? Image, system named. And this, I have to copy it out from my notes. So I'm not going to have any typos. And also, let's have a foreground style of maybe blue, so we can just maybe tap on it. Let's have a padding. Of course, you can add in here also a button. And let's have a background in capsule. Dot capsule. So let's check this out. There we go. We have our King's Cross right over there. Now, just a quick one. Let's have this inside a navigation link with the destination and a label. So the label would be this one. And the destination, I'm just going to go with the text of King's Cross. Well, let me just copy the label out. And that's where we are going to navigate. Of course, we need to set up a navigation stack for that. So let's go and do that. Navigation stack outside of the content view. Let's come back to the content view. Let's build and run. And let's see this really cool annotation. And if we click on it, you can see that we are navigating away. Now, this is cool and all, but we can also style our map. So let's have on the map itself a dot map style. And you can have here different values. Let's just have a hybrid imagery, standard hybrid. But I like to play around with the hybrid because we have a lot of options right over here, like elevation, let's just have a realistic points of interest. This is really, really great. Let's just have public transport. We want to have points of interest with including public transport. So dot including, and here is our array, and that is dot public transport. Showing traffic, let's set that to true. Let's build it around, let's see how our map is going to change. You see, it's really, really nice. Also, we can add in map controls. So just with a simple view modifier, we just add map controls. And let's just see what can we have here. Well, we can have a map pitch toggle. Also a map user location button. If we just tap on it, it will just jump into our current, the user's current location. And also we can have a map compass, so we can just show where is north. Now, because I'm not using CL location or whatever right over here, we will not be able to jump into our current location, but you can, because we are in London, we can change between 2D and 3D just like that. It's really, really nice. Now, this is by no means an easy task to set up. These APIs are really, really great, but it's not for junior developers. But if you are interested in a junior developer interview question, go ahead and check out the video that's right over here.